Hello, my Scrap Family, it's Photograph here, and welcome back to another adventure with me. And welcome back to Stormworks, and welcome to another one of Silly Goody Ships. This is, yet another small passenger cargo ship. This is called the SS Humboldt. This is the ship that, carries passengers, because it's a passenger ship, duh. What am I saying? She got four past the funnel. She was a little of the 1800s, apparently I can tell, because I read the descriptions and saw that her year thing was in 1889, but yeah, no, that doesn't matter. What matters is the stern looks nice. He has been improving on the sterns, like, back then they looked much weirder, but now they look awesome. They just look awesome. And yes, he is currently working on a ship right now. I'm not gonna say it to the details because I don't want to spoil it for anybody. So yeah, you're just gonna wait whether you like it or not. Yeah though, we got four lifeboats. She has a sister ship, the SS Harris. She is known as the Unlucky Lady. She had some engine troubles and had no less than 5 collisions. She had somehow survived her service and was sold for scrap. For some reason, whilst the Humboldt, in spite of being so lucky and not like the Harriscue, she sank herself and remained the worst disaster until apparently the Humboldt Castle, which no, is not the name of the new ship, but spoiler alert, it's Art Deco. Anyhow though, let's have a look around. Right, so, I'm not sure whether you saw this on the last video or not, but Stormworks made an update, whereas you can see more information about components. So, yeah, I'm gonna go over that first, like this engine telegraph. We're losing electricity, but it's only here in this area somehow, because everywhere else it's fine. We got the bridge wing. I mean, it's okay, but I think it could be better if we were put more to the front, you know? Not like all the way in the back and looking back here. I don't know. Something tells me I should give it a 7 out of 10. Hopefully, the new ship's bridge wing will be okay. Anyway, so, we've seen everything in the bridge and we can go down here into, top deck, I'm guessing, because, yeah. I sometimes like to call it the boat deck because this is where the lifeboats are, just so you know. And deck house. So we have the deck house, but we got light boots. So we got the officer's deck house. This is where you have the wireless room. And you know what the wireless room does, duh. We can go down these stairs, and there's stairs on the other side too, in case you're curious. This will be out here, but right now we want to travel through the crew quarters. Sadly, none of the crew cabins are available. It's only the passenger cabins. And all of them. But yeah, here we got the crew / lower class dining saloon. This is where your lower class is gonna eat. Fun fact about lower class, I think at least back then, back in those days, where if you didn't bring your own food, you don't get to eat. They're not cooking for you. Yeah, and then you got like the lower class entrance, or maybe an open space or general room. After open space, it'd be at the cargo hold. Alright, so in general, maybe that'd be at the stern. I don't really know. I've been seeing too much Titanic. Ugh. So yeah, we go down here into B deck, A deck, top deck. Top deck or T deck. We can go into cargo number 2. This is where you carry the cargo because she's also a cargo ship as well. And passenger cargo ship. I can say I call her passenger cargo ship because her cargoes are big. Oh dear god. You can go in here. Sadly, no boiler rooms, but nowadays, the way he makes it, it's kind of hard to add a boiler room. The most recent one we have. The most recent ship we have with the boiler room is the Henwick. Well, Hotcliffe as well, but yeah. And we go here. This is a cabin hallway with some rooms. There's no rooms available here, but I will go over them. So all of these are the same exact thing. We're going for only one cabin. So this is a third class cabin, or lower class cabin. I call it first and third class just cause. Yeah, porthole, and yes, I did set it to nighttime because I thought it'd be a bit different. I like being random sometimes, you know. And then you got four beds right here, so these are quadruple cabins. That means they carry a lot. And yes, there's heaters, and there's a reason why they're off right now. Yeah, let me show you. But first, let's go into the medical bay. There's only room for one and map screen. Yeah, it shows the names microcontrols now. See, it's a microcontroller. They just did it again. Oh my god. Yeah. Well, only one milk bed though. Tough sharing. And then we got the galley storage. As I was doing this off camera, I completely forgot about this room. And yeah. Yeah, so most of this is like, all these are just not actually functioning. That's the thing about this. Like, they take stuff, and you know, I'm not gonna say, I've said it like a million times, but whatever, what the heck. They take the stuff and they just reform it into decoration, you know? Yeah, that's galley storage, and over here we got a toilet, and that's a toilet. That's definitely a toilet. Toilet paper that doesn't actually function. Look at the galley. Ooh, look at the galley. And here we got this thing, stove and ovens. We got shelves, a cutter, and we got an electric whisk, whatever the heck it is. However, it does nothing. Ha! And don't worry about the list, it won't capsize it like lists like that. Crew only. Oh, this is definitely not crew only, my friends. We're stepping straight into first class. So, without further ado, let's go ahead and tour one of these cabins, because all of them are the same exact thing. This is number 3, apparently, so this time, the cabins are numbered. This is a double cabin, so she can only these cabins can only carry 2. Thank you, Captain Obvious. Got a clock that does actually work. Yeah, it's gonna stay 804 forever and ever and ever and ever and ever. We got heaters. There's no lights. Might be a problem. Maybe the heater could act as a wee bit of a lighting. But yeah, though. And going here, we've got the dinning saloon. Apparently, it's not dining saloon. It's dinning saloon. You're mistaken. Yeah, this is upper class, though it looks like a lower class dining saloon. I mean, there's detail, and I mean, you can see the walls are painted. Yeah, it just doesn't got that upper class style to it, you know? And this is the galley. We've been here before, so therefore we don't have to tour that once again. Here, we got the here room. This is the reason why the heres are off. This is an Anderson Shipyard Boilermaker. And Boilermaker. Boiler temperature, that's 0. We want that to be 100. Let's turn boiler on and see the boilers going up. Therefore, thusly turning on all heaters in existence known to man. Anyhow, that's about all on in this area. We got the back here, and this will be about all. After we tour these rooms, so this is the library. This is where you read a book. I like the detail, very nice detail. Thing about this is that I can't get here easily. Spoiler alert. Because that hole there, he hit it very well. Got 3 portholes you can look out from. Can I see the moon? No, hi moon. How's it going? Yeah. We're gonna go over here. We got a toilet for upper class. This is for upper class, not lower class. And then we got a smoking room. Look at this. And sorry, 10 minutes into the video. I need a floor. Right. This is smoking room. This is where you smoke. The STL's first ship, the SS Hatfield. Yeah, we need to go through those older ships as well. Though I'm gonna do some modern ships made by other people, because I don't want to do the same exact thing. I don't want to do the ships by the same exact person all at once, because that's dumb. You know, we can go up here. This is the upper class entrance. We have the purser's office. This is the purser's office. It's where he purses through people. Whatever the heck I'm saying. This might also kind of be like a lounge, you know, you got seats there. This could be a lounge. And then, yeah, that's about all on the Humboldt. Yeah, this cargo hold is not available. Yeah, we just finished the tour of the Humboldt. It's not phones here, but it's good enough. Definitely good enough. I love it. Like, I love these old liners. Like, big liners are fun, but we do need some of these older, small liners. They're also fun as well. Alright, well, I'm gonna go into my captain's non-existent cabin, and yeah, I'm just gonna go sleep. Hopefully, nothing horrible happens whilst I am sleeping. So, without further ado, let's get some sleep. Oh my god. I decided to sleep here because I wanted to sleep in the captain's cabin or cabin, and I realized the captain's cabin didn't exist. So, yeah. Should we just go back to port? I mean, there's no other ports left, and something goes 8 knots. We need a photo video. Folks. Oh, God. Not again. Come on, game. I just woke up. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? I don't know. Oh, is that really a tsunami, or am I just dreaming? Am I just hallucinating? Because I slept way... I went to sleep way too late. Seriously, I actually did in real life. Like, this morning. But yeah. This is a problem. We need to turn harder starboard. Fast. Alright. We'll see once it finally gets here. Guys, I don't think we're gonna make it. We might capsize. I don't know. It really just depends. Okay? Oh, it's gonna be fine. It's gonna be A-okay. Just keep turning hard port. Do you hear that? Okay. Weird noise, but yeah, though. It should be fine. Right. Let's go. Why are we... Lights fucking... What's going on? I assure you I did nothing, guys. We're listening to port. No. And we're gonna get hit broadside by a tsunami. One fire stress rocket before the tsunami gets us. For good luck. Okay. Time to embrace it. I'm not screaming. Because one, I don't want to make my sister up. Because every single time I get in trouble, it's always because I wait just because of my sister. Apparently. Sometimes the world just has to revolve around her. Some days. Anyways though, enough about my sister. And more on the tsunami that we're getting picked up by. Yeah, this is a problem, man. I don't quite like this. We're literally exactly broadside to it. We could capsize and we're already capsizing. We're like listening to port. I think we should be fine. Or maybe we might list the port some more. Oh crap. Oh no, hold on tight, everybody. And whoa. Ship. Oh, I know you're listening to port, but come on. Yes, keep rolling. There's a lifeboat on the hull. Why did I pause? I don't know why. Okay, that's it. Stop the engines. Oh my god. She's listening to port. I don't know what to do. Oh god, she's... Wait a minute. Wow, okay. Why is that on? Well, I think it's too late now. Just launch some flares or something. All the light puts are gone, so screw that. Screw the idea of the light puts. I'm gonna be a rebel and go down there. Fire pen rockets. And... gonna get a distressing thought there. Oh, the power's out. Yeah, the power's cut. We can't get signal to any ships. Gosh dang it. Come on. Come on. Get up the railing. What's your problem, game? Come on. Ooh, that is a horrible list. What a fancy list. Yes, fancy list. Okay, one of the cabins are flooding! I'm just gonna go, oh god. Yeah. Spoiler alert, this guy did try to make this capsize, but it's as far as it's gonna get. Actually, I like it. This way. Yeah, though, come on, get up this here. I can't get up anything because everything's diagonal. Oh no, I'm not gonna get stuck in chairs. That's the thing I'm very good at doing, apparently. Your fault, Tsunami! Though we're sinking for absolutely no reason once again. Let's go ahead and... Why are we moving? Game. What is it with this game? It messes with me. Gosh dang it. We're taking the head trim. I think we're gonna take our final plunge. Let's see what's going on down here first. Yeah, that doesn't look good, folks. Oh, that's a lot of flooding. Too much flooding. Yeah, there's water coming. The cargo is flying. Yeah, whoa. Just take a fan punch. Okay. The engine stopped. Oh, no, the light was revivable. Just get on the capsize one. It doesn't really matter anymore. Alright, just survive. Oh, god. Survive, therefore I win. Yeah, surviving is the same thing as winning, right? I don't know, depends on my definition. Oh, come on, jump! Oh, I got off just in the nick of time. Look at that, she's literally sinking. Taking a final plunge. The Humboldt is gone with that. As I said in a different way. I'm blaming the Tsunami for this. Alright, well, whilst I'm suffering on the lifeboat with no other lifeboat right side up, I'm going to leave the episode here. I hope you did enjoy as much as I enjoyed suffering from a tsunami whilst my ship sinking for, once again, no reason whatsoever. It just wants to. Somehow. It just sank. But yeah, though. Please make sure to subscribe. Helps out my channel. And yes! Oh my gosh, just stand on the tail and it'll work. As long as it doesn't... Come on. All hope ain't lost. We didn't get to send the stress signal because we lost the power. And I ran out of time to do it. Well, power was cut right away. Though you launched rockets on those morning time. And yeah, that was it. It wasn't the tsunami that sank the ship. It was the ship that sank itself. It just decided to sink all of a sudden. For absolutely no reason other than it wants to be a jerk to me. So, if you enjoy this, thank you for watching. And I do have some new ships out there. Botanica, Nomadica, and Lucridia. One of them is not in Matt's Atlantic line. And that's Lucridia. And you can tell because it doesn't end with Ica. He has to end with Ica to be in my company. It doesn't have to, exactly. Well, not all of them have to, but you get the idea. Anyways, thank you for watching, and I will see you later. Bye-bye.